Hi, my name is Jamal Lopez. I'm the customer service manager over at SciAps, and today we'll be going over how to change prolene and kapton windows on our XRF units. Today, first, we'll get started on our X505. It's the same process for our X5 units, 550 and 555 units. Let's get right into it. First, you got to start by removing the nose plate. After we remove the nose plate, it's very important that you're delicate with the inside of the unit. You don't want to puncture anything inside or damage anything internally. Okay, next, we'll move the window off. It's very important that you try to get all the excess glue off of it. You don't want to, damage the next prolene window or the next kapton window or affect it with its performance. These will be kind of difficult to get off, so it's okay to put some pressure on there. It's just very important to be gentle with the next one that you put on. Just like that, make sure it's sealed and flush. We'll put it right back on this unit. Like I said, just make sure everything is sealed and flush. You don't want anything, any contamination, because this will affect your shots. That's good. Next, we'll be jumping right into our X50 model. The nose plates on this model versus the 505 and the 550s, they're not the exact same, but they're very similar. So changing the kapton and the prolene windows are pretty much the same process. We'll start by removing the nose plate. Again, not the same, but very similar. You can put some pressure in on this to get the glue off, get the window off, because you will just be putting a brand new one on there. Once flush, you're good to go. Put the nose plate right back on the unit. Just like that. Next, we'll be moving into our X550 unit. This one's a little different. The nose plate isn't the same as our X505 units or any of our other units. This one requires an Allen wrench, which comes in the kit that we provide for you. On the other units, when you remove the nose plate, the screws will stay in with the nose plate. There's four screws, they will stay in there for the most part. On this one, as you can see already, these can tend to get lost pretty fast and they're very small. So just be very careful and gentle with these, please. Again, we're gonna remove this prolene window, replace it with another prolene windows, but the process is the same for prolene and kapton windows. It's okay to put some pressure. It's gonna be stuck on there pretty good because of the glue. Once the window's on there, you can go ahead, put the plate right back on. Again, make sure you don't lose your screws, which I just did. I'll grab another one very shortly, but there you go. Now you see that these screws are very important. I'll grab another one here. And there you go. So that's how you change prolene and kapton windows on our X5 2.0, 3.0 XRF series. If you have any other questions and concerns, please don't be afraid to call us or email us at support@sciops.com. Thank you.